All right. How about that? Not terrible for the first theme song the Deviled Advocates ever had. You know who wrote that? Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Was it Johann Sebastian Bach? Was it John Williams? Was it Hank Williams? No, it was me. It was your boy. It was old Sam. Yeah, I found myself fiddling around on my iPad, because I'm a consumeristic kind of guy, and I was fiddling away, not on a fiddle, not on a violin, same instrument, I'm pretty sure, just depends on the style of music, but found myself writing a little song, you know, and I have zero capability when it comes to musical instruments and stuff like that. I've had a guitar since I was like 13, and I only know 5 chords, so, I mean, I can play like Wonderwall and stuff, but I don't think that means I'm good at anything. Luckily for me, GarageBand has this super nifty option where you can like, they have a bunch of like autoplay options, so like, I didn't write that bass riff, I didn't write that guitar riff. Or piano, or I guess it was organ, I think, maybe a synthesizer. I should know what kind of instruments I use if I want to claim that I made the song, but you gotta believe me, I made it. But yeah, I wrote it all with their help, you know, helpful algorithm, and it's the same. I use GarageBand to record this monstrosity of an ego stroke fest. But, I don't know why GarageBand doesn't have an autoplay option for podcasting. Because I could just click a bunch of buttons and maybe I would say things that made sense. Or I would be able to keep some sort of structure. But no, I have to do this all on my own. Come on, GarageBand, you're better than that. I'm not, but you are. I don't know, y'all. I hope this finds you chillin'. You know that. I'm chillin', obviously. I've been chillin' so hard lately. Feels like a year ago that I graduated from college, but man, it's been a week. A week since I took my last final, so it's been good. It's been good. I've been writing a lot. I wrote a script last week, and that's good. We're going to start doing production meetings on that this weekend, so hopefully be shooting a film within the next month. It's been so chill. I've been like napping because I have nothing else to do. And I mean, granted, I have 1,000 other things I should be doing, but none of them have like real deadlines because I'm not in school anymore. So I just take naps. It's not great. I gotta get out of it. Like, I've been skipping the gym to take random naps. So, going back to the gym today, the day you're listening to this, and I'm gonna sweat it out and hopefully develop some sort of adult life routine where I go to the gym regularly and I stop going like 2 months in, and then it's just hard to go back. But I think, you know, tomorrow I'm just gonna do it. I'm just gonna go back in and I'm gonna puddle some sweat, you know. I'm gonna maybe drink a Gatorade to recoup some ions and electrolytes, you know. It's terrible. But yeah, with all this spare time, I'm finally gonna get to that second podcast about shows and music. Gonna do the first segment. I got a good buddy I'm gonna have on for I think like the first 12 episodes. We're just going to dissect Weezer, and he doesn't like Weezer, so I'm going to try and get him into Weezer. We'll see. I think I might drop a clip of it at the end, just to give you guys a little teaser. I think you might enjoy it. And yeah, so just trying to keep busy, trying to stay as creative as possible. I don't know. It's weird being a postgraduate with an arts degree, you know? I have a screenwriting degree, which means probably the best entry-level position that I can get, which I already have, is delivering pizzas. So think I'm going to keep doing that for a while. You know, it's decent money. The hours are, I like the hours. My coworkers are chill. I can take all the time off I want. I got benefits. I got vacation. You know, it's not bad. I'm making double digits an hour, you know, quadruple digits if you count the ones after the decimal. It's not terrible. It's not the best. Be cool to get paid to write, but for now I'm just gonna keep slanging pies. Keep slanging pies, keep writing and making movies. Should be pretty fun. Yeah. This weekend I had a little graduation party to celebrate me, obviously, because having a podcast isn't enough. I need to have actual events where people come and validate my existence and my accomplishments. And it was awesome. Like, there was a great turnout. I had friends from all three of the colleges I've went to show up. A couple buddies from work, which was really neat. Oh, it was really neat. What a stupid... It wasn't neat and tidy. It was messy. You know, I felt like I couldn't talk to anybody for more than 30 seconds at a time before I was getting pulled away to a different group. It was bonkers. But guys, everybody who came out, if you're listening to this, I really appreciated it. It was awesome. Hope to see y'all more often than I have in the last few years, but let's be realistic. None of us are making the effort, you know. Let's get together when we can and keep having fun. But I want to shout out a few people specifically that came by and had some just lovely words to share about the podcast. First off, I want to shout out Seabiscuit and Boots, an old roommate from my Duluth days and his lady friend. You guys were so nice. You listen to me when you go on trips, and it sounds like you're going on a lot of trips this summer, so I gotta keep recording these for you. That's awesome. I really appreciate that. You know, if you want to share it with your friends and family, feel free. You know, whatever. If you need me to advertise anything you're doing in your daily lives, let me know. I'll see what I can do. I'll see what old Sam can do for you. Boots taught me something which I felt so dumb for not knowing. So, she's a teacher, right? Big hoity-toity real adult job after college like a normal person. And me, a pizza guy, had to learn that tenure does not mean 10 years. Like, at her school, she's only got to work there for 3 years before she gets tenure. And that's hardly an accomplishment. At any rate, like, I got tenured at Papa John's because I've been there for, like, 4 years. And this is the most uncomfortable brag that I have about Papa John's. I've been there for 4 years. But I guess I'm kind of tenured. They can't fire me. You know, they can't fire a guy who works six mornings a week, does all the prep. I don't know. Here I am, beep, boop, bopping my own horn again. But, yeah, I don't know. I always thought it meant you worked there for a decade and then they couldn't fire you because you'd put a solid 10 years in. I mean, yeah, I looked it up. I checked it out on Wikipedia. I said, well, I didn't even get to Wikipedia. I just typed in 10 and then the third option was 10 year, kind of like manure, but with a 10 in front of it instead of a man. But yeah, pretty interesting. Another shout out to Mary, a good pal. Told me about a couple specific stories that she really enjoyed and they made her feel for me, or they made her laugh. And guys, I'm not great at taking compliments as much as I seek, like, that aspect of life. If there's something about the show you guys like, let me know. You know, it makes my day. It makes doing this extra worth it. I mean, it's worth it just for me hear myself talk for a half an hour a week, but knowing that people enjoy it, it would bring me to tears if I wasn't so dang dehydrated, you know? But yeah, so thanks for listening. I don't know. It was just a blast to see all those friends and to get all those compliments. You know what? I shouldn't just talk about if you like the show. I should assume that you don't, because you probably don't. But I'm much better at taking insults. So if there's anything you dislike about the show, if you just hate my voice, if you hate my face and you've never even seen it, but you know you hate it because of my voice, tell me. Tell me you want to punch me in the mouth, which would affect both my voice and my face. Tell me you think the stories I tell are dumb. Tell me that tell me something that I'm not already telling myself on a daily basis about the show. Attack me personally, you know? Make fun of my family. I don't care. Just don't compliment me, you know? Because that makes me feel all weird and squishy inside. I mean, I'm already squishy on the outside, but I don't need to be squishy on the inside, too. I don't know. It's been a week, right? I recorded a week ago, it's been another week, but it's also been a week. You're like, ugh, what a week. So get this. I got this new segment that I'm going to do called Dummies of the Week. It's not just dummies, I'm also going to do the Heroes of the Week. Sponsored by Subway. I think I talked about that a bit ago. Probably 10 episodes ago. Never did it again. But I'm gonna start focusing on these people that I see every day that I just look at and I go, how are you such a dummy? How did you leave the house such a dummy, right? So, first person started out as a hero, right? I see him go through a stoplight, or not through a he crosses an intersection, and he's riding on a bicycle. Not hero-worthy because he's saving the environment, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Hero-worthy because he's riding it backwards. And he's not sitting on it right and pedaling it backwards. He is sitting on the handlebars and pedaling with his back facing the direction he's going, right? Awesome. Super cool. Very talented, very quirky. Props to that guy for being Zooey Deschanel and, like, Olympic skeleton at the same time. Like, extremely quirky. Amazing. Not so much shout out to that guy for swerving and nearly causing me to run into him, because every time he would look forwards, which in this case was backwards, or he would look backwards, which in this case was forwards. Who cares? He would twist his body, which was sitting on the steering device of the two-wheeled transportation deal. And that would make him swerve. And it was incredibly dangerous. This is on one of the main infrastructure streets in the Twin Cities. In the Twin Metropolitan Area. This road runs through the whole thing, and he's in a hub. We're in a college campus neighborhood, and he's riding his bike backwards like a dummy. Get out of here. Go, like, the circus was in town. Did they forget this clown? This acrobatic goofball? I don't know. I don't care for him, though. I haven't gone from love to hate so quickly since, like, the last time I ate an entire sleeve of Thin Mint cookies in a sitting. And that's saying something, because I haven't done that for a while. So there's been a... He was the worst. I don't know if I'm going to be able to sleep tonight because of how mad at this guy I am. And I shouldn't be that bad. He was doing something extremely cool, talented, dangerous. And yeah, dangerous, like, definitely equals cool, if I'm being honest, right? And now that I think about it, had he not nearly swerved into my car, and, you know, caused me to manslaughter him. Because I'm not trying to be a manslaughterer. I don't want a man, I don't want to slaughter anybody. And why isn't it human slaughter, you know? Or person slaughter? Why does it have to be so gender specific, you know? I'm so sick of that. Ugh. I'm also sick of Coca-Cola not being called Cola Coca. I think it sounds better. I think it's more fun to say. And I'm also drinking a Coca-Cola right now. It makes my teeth feel weird, and I gotta... This is the first soda I've had in a really long time, and I just wanted a Coke out of the can. You know? I just wanted to get a nice ice-cold Coke out of the can, and now my teeth feel weird, and I'm mad at this guy for riding me the wrong way. I think if I was on the opposite side of the street and I saw this guy doing this, I would have loved it entirely. I would have maybe, you know, and now that I've come to this realization, I think maybe he's a hero of the week. So I'm going to call him a hero / dummy of the week. So he did pretty well. He did outstanding in both categories, and that takes extremely quirky talent. Another guy this morning, I was getting gas before work, right? Which I know what you're thinking. No, I wasn't eating beans before work. I was filling up my car. I was putting gas in my Ford Escape. You know, I wasn't shoveling down a can of bushes. Idiots. You guys are the dummies if that's what you think. But there's this guy in line, and he had these big old swishy pants on, which he had one leg rolled up halfway up his shin. Dude was, I mean, he was bona fide out of his mind. It had come from like the methadone clinic down the road, and just, oh man, out of his mind, right? And the lady at the counter is like, he pays for a coffee, and then she walks around the counter without taking his money and grabs his pocket. I felt bad for him. I was like, what the heck? This is, oh man, how awkward. That's a violation. What's in my pockets is my business. But I'm also not the one stealing sausage biscuits from a gas station at 10 in the morning, you know? So like, if she squeezed my pocket, I would have freaked out just like he did. She grabs his pocket and he's like, what'd you do that for? Blah, blah, blah. And she's like, you're stealing. And he's like, I'm not stealing. She's like, what's in your pocket? And he's like, it's change. Or he said it's money. And he shook his pocket, and it was for sure, there's probably 10 pounds of change in there. And I don't know how his big old swishy pants didn't fall off. But anyway, so he starts cussing at her, and she starts cussing at him. And like, I mean, he's clearly had a rough life given where he came from. And I mean, I don't want to say she's had a rough life given where she is, but a 50-plus-year-old person working at a gas station, not uncommon in the world. Uncommon to see a 50-plus-year-old woman cussing out a dude, you know? It was hilarious. It was hilarious to see him cussing her out. And then she called over another one of the clerks, and, like, that clerk just stood there and watched him, which was weird because, like, she was this small girl, but, like, very intimidating. And yeah, she was like, what's in your pocket? And he put his hand in his pocket and he wouldn't take it out. So then they're like, fine, get out of here. Never come back to my store. And he's like, I've never even been here. And they're like, you steal all the time. That's why we knew to check you. And it might have been profiling, but I don't think so. But yeah, so he leaves. And then he comes back and he starts cussing her out some more. Being like, I didn't steal. My bus isn't here yet. Blah, blah, blah. You had no right. And I'm like, man, you got a free sandwich. Get out of here. And you know what? During that whole commotion, I actually snuck four bacon, egg, and cheese burritos into my cargo shorts pockets. So they didn't see that. They didn't notice that. But he leaves again, and he goes to his bus stop. And the whole time he's standing there, he's just got two middle fingers in the air, just flipping off the store. And the lady behind the counter is like not ringing me up for my gas, and she just keeps like thrusting her arms out, like staring him down, like doing the, come on, what are you going to do about it, punk? Come back to my store. Let's see. Hilarious. So this is an unheard of double dummy situation, right? Like she had all the right in the world to be mad. And he, given his opinions and what he wants to do, he had all the right in the world to steal a sandwich and cuss her out. But it was stupid. You know, like, dog, it's a $1.50. $1.50 is a lot to a lot of people. In fact, I have to pay $1.75 to do each portion of my laundry, wash, dry. $3.50 per load. It's asinine. My landlords are... Oh, I'll get to my landlords in a minute. They're the third dummy of the week. But yeah, he stole a breakfast sandwich and cussed a lady out, and she sunk to his level, and I embarrassed herself in front of a store full of people. But that makes me think. I'm thinking about her, and I'm talking about her, and this situation, and this guy, right? And the guy on the bike, right, who nearly hit me, or nearly made me manslaughter him, like, I wonder if those people are thinking about me. Did the guy who was on his bike, did he get scared for his life and, like, think, oh, no, I almost maybe would have gotten that guy 5 to 10 years in a penitentiary because of accidental manslaughter? And, like, is the guy at the gas station, like, embarrassed at how he acted? Or the woman, like, is she, next time she sees me, is she gonna be like, oh, this guy saw me, like, trying to fight an ex-heroin addict. Maybe current heroin addict, I don't know. I don't think people think about me as much as I think about people. And I don't think people think about me as much as I think people think about me, you know? I might have just said the same thing twice in a row, but I don't think people are thinking about us, you know? And that's kind of, it's kind of like, I find solace in it, but it's also disheartening, you know? Like, if someone mistreats me and it ruins my day and I can't stop thinking about it, if they're not thinking about it, you know, like, what's the point in me thinking about it? Why can't I stop thinking about it? It's this weird phenomenon, you know? I don't fully understand it. I'm deeply interested in why. And maybe it's just because of the podcast and feeling the need to be a storyteller in general that I notice these things and I hang on to them. But I don't know. I'd be curious to hear the lady at the gas station record a podcast about her day today. See what kind of people she brings into it. If it's just her, if it's about people she encountered, I don't know. Third dummy of the week, my landlords. I'm not gonna name their company, but I don't know why. I don't know. I don't think they could do anything to me. Mint Properties. You guys are a joke. You're a bunch of jerks. We had to give them a 2-month notice to move out, and we told them on May 1st that we wanted to move out on July 1st, and because we didn't tell them before the end of the month, before the end of April, we now have to pay rent in a house that none of us are going to be living in. It's a joke. What do you want? We were 24 hours late. And now we have to give you an extra $2,600 or whatever the total is of our rent. I'm not happy, and I'm calling them dummies because I'm mad at them and I think they're dumb. I think on paper they're a business. They don't care about people. You know, on paper businesses don't care about people, and then they got us. There wasn't a loophole. They figured it out, you know? This is how they make money. So, I don't like you, Mint Properties. You're dumb, and I'm never going to rent for you again, and I'm going to tell everybody that you're a bad company that I talk to who's looking for a place and say I wouldn't recommend you. Partially because you don't give us notice when you're coming. Secondly, because you tell us to move our cars by 8 a.m. on a Sunday because you're going to plow. And then you show up to plow at 7 p.m. when all of our cars are back in the lot because we got to park somewhere. And it's our fault that you didn't come plow when you said you were going to plow. If, you know, is the issue that you tell all of your thousands of properties that you're going to plow at the same time? Because that doesn't make any sense. You got to layer it out. You got to be better. Because our lot never got plowed. You're a joke. Charging, like I said moments ago, $1.75 to wash and to dry a load. That's insane. Right? Like, the washer you put in the house can hold more clothes than the dryer can dry on one load, right? So you can wash more than you can dry. So every full load you do comes out to be 2 cycles in the dryer. So that's not even $3.50. That's $5.25 if I'm doing that math right. It's expensive. And like, say you're doing a load of towels. Good luck. You know, good luck getting those dry without having to take out a mortgage, you know, a second mortgage on the house you rent. I'm actually mad about this. I'm upset. I am not a happy camper. That's such an easy phrase to imagine. Not a happy camper. Like, a lot of colloquialisms, or whatever, however you say that word. A lot of those don't make a lot of sense. Not a happy camper. Easy to imagine. There's mosquitoes. I'm not happy. I'm camping. It's raining. Boy, am I not happy. I'm camping. You know? There's a serial killer on the loose, and he was last seen at entering the forest that we're camping in. I'm camping, but I'm not happy. You know? Easy to imagine. So we got a hero this week, right? We got just, and I've thought this might be controversial. I've always thought the phrase Blue Lives Matter was kind of dumb and counterproductive to what Black Lives Matter was doing. But this is not a political podcast. I'm not going to get into it. But this situation the other day, it was the first time #BlueLivesMatter really sunk in for me, right? I'm parked at, like, there's this weird intersection where a train curves and it blocks 2 lanes of traffic fully, but it doesn't obscure the lane of traffic I was in at all. And so there one train went north to south, and then the other one came south to north, and the light was red for like 4.5 minutes, right? And I'm 3 cars back, and there's like 9 or 10 cars behind me, and there's a cop at the front of the line, right? And his lights turn on, and he just starts, first of all, he puts his hand out his window, and he starts waving along, right? And then he throws the lights on, gives it a bloop, bloop, and then he just waves some more, and everybody drives through the red light. It was amazing. You know, I think it would be so funny if there was like 12 sting operation cars hidden like blocks ahead, and they just pulled us all over and wrote a bunch of tickets for running a red light. But at the same time, that didn't happen, and this cop saved me maybe another 5 minutes waiting at this lane that there's no reason it should have been a red light. Thank you, officer. I don't know who you are. I don't know what precinct you're in, but I, from the bottom of my heart, appreciate what you did for me the other day. And not to belittle your daily, you know, heroics or whatever, I appreciate that. I'm a fan of the cops. I'm not a fan of them, but they've never done me wrong. That's my privilege, which I don't want to talk about. I think that's a part of my curse. I just don't want to talk about it. Maybe I will someday. Maybe I'll come to grips with how I was born, but not today. So anyway, that segment, Dummies and Heroes, D&H, I'll come up with something better. Or I won't. Yeah, I don't really care about quality of things. You guys, if you're listening, you obviously know that. Gonna do that segment. Oh, it was brought to you by Subway. I don't know if I said that. Anyway, I'm gonna say it again just for rule of three if I did, or, you know, make it another mistake if I didn't. That segment and this previous advertisement were both brought to you by Subway. They weren't really, but Subway, if you're listening, I enjoy your sandwiches. I had one last week. Got the BMT. Really enjoyed it. Love Subway. I'm going to go ahead and say it. I like Subway more than Jimmy John's. There's a Jimmy John's across the street from my house, diagonally, literally, half a block away. I'll go to Subway 9 out of 10 times instead of going to Jimmy John's. It's a controversial topic, you know, but Jimmy John's is good. It's quick, but you can't customize and they don't have pickles. And these aren't original thoughts. Everybody knows them, but they still say Jimmy John's is better. Whatever. They're both associated with criminals. So I don't know if I should be eating sandwiches anymore. I don't know. Oh, wow. Look at that. Broke a half an hour. What a day. I'm gonna leave you guys with the best joke that I have in my phone right now, and it is pretty good. I'm gonna end every segment with a joke that I haven't quite finished yet and am working on. Yeah, give me 1 second. I gotta find my phone. All right, I am back. It took me a while to find it. I left it in the bathroom. You know what they say, you can't go to the bathroom without having your phone, and you can't leave the bathroom without leaving your phone. And that's not even the joke. Could be. Maybe not. Not that good. Not even good at all. So this is more of a thought than a fully formed joke, but it's the one at the top of the list. It means I wrote it the most recent. And here goes. Hoagie is a good insult. Bread for both your head and feet. Good luck walking. Meat for a body? That's pretty normal. But what's this? No pickles? Get out of here. Yeah, that's it. Alright, enjoy the snippet of the new podcast I'm going to throw in here at the end. I'll talk to you guys whenever.
You look great.
D-Rock, you look good like too, you, baby.
You're wearing your leisure, your cruise wear. You look fantastic.
Uh-huh. Have I look important, right?
No, very important.
Like I got a diploma or something.
Yeah.
You smell good. You got that good cologne on.
Thank you very much.
High karate. I want to thank you on your Kennedy Center's Honors Award.
Well, that's very good.
You know, I was at...
You were. And thanks to you. I couldn't have done it without you. Thanks
well,
for
you
your
know
help,
it was supposed to go
support.
To me.
I heard that, yes.
And I was waiting for you in the parking lot.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to get that award. It probably wouldn't have said my name, but
no,
I would have had it.
I wish you had gotten it. Now, let's talk about the big news. This is the last season of 30 Rock. Have you filmed the last show?
Yes, we have.
Was it an emotionally charged
moment?
Very.
Me and Tina went through like two boxes of Kleenexes.
Mm-hmm.
Because I had a cold and I just had to keep blowing my nose. No, I'm just joking. Just but it.
Yeah. But did you... What, it's all right. It's okay, he's with me. Did you, no, he's fine. Did you, wait, can you tell us, give us a hint as to how the show ends?
No, I can't do that.
No, you can.
No!
Yes, you can, you're
Tracy
Morgan.
There gotta be a surprise for these guys.
Oh, come on, let us, give us a little something.
A little something?
Yeah.
Thanks for listening. Can't wait for next week. Bye.